वासुदेवाय
वंदेहं श्रीगुरु श्रीयुता पदकमलं
So, to understand Krishna is little difficult. Actually, to understand God is a subject matter, very difficult. But the God Himself is explaining Himself in the Bhagavad Gita. I am like this, I am like this. This material nature is like this, the spiritual nature is like this, the living entities are like this. Everything are completely described in the Bhagavad Gita. God Himself giving His own knowledge. And that is the only process to understand God. Otherwise, by speculation, we cannot understand God. It is not possible. He is unlimited and we are limited. Our knowledge, our perception, all of that are very limited. So how we can understand the unlimited? But if we accept the version of the unlimited, that He is like this, like that, then we can understand. That is perfect knowledge. Speculative knowledge of God has no value. Real knowledge. Just like, I give this example. That's like if a boy wants to know who is his father. The simple thing is to ask mother, or mother gives, here is your father. That is perfect knowledge. And if you speculate, who is my father? And ask the whole city, are you my father? Are you my father? Are you my father? The knowledge will always remain imperfect. He'll never find out what is his father. But this simple process, if he takes the knowledge from his father, the authority, mother, my dear boy, here is your father. Then your knowledge is perfect. Similarly, transcendental knowledge, just like I was speaking, that there is a spiritual world. It is not the subject matter of our speculation. But when God says, yes, there is a spiritual world, that is my headquarters. That is all right. Yes. So we receive knowledge from Krishna, the best authority. Therefore our knowledge is perfect. We are not perfect, but our knowledge is perfect. Because we receive knowledge from the perfect. The same example, that I am not perfect to understand who is my father, but my mother is perfect. And because I accept the perfect knowledge of my mother, therefore my knowledge of father is perfect. So, this Krishna consciousness movement is for giving perfect knowledge to the human society. What he is, what is God? What is this material world? Why you have come here? Why you have to undergo so much tribulations? Miserable condition of life? Why I die? I do not like to die. But death is compulsory. I do not like to be old man. Still, it is compulsory. I do not like to suffer from disease. But it is compulsory. These are to be solved. That is really problems of human life. Not that improving the method of eating, sleeping, mating and defending. That is not human life. A man sleeps, a dog sleeps. So, because a man sleeps in a very nice apartment, that does not mean he is advanced more than the dog. The business is sleeping. That's all. Because man has discovered atomic weapon for defending, and that dog has his nails and teeth, he can also defend. So defending is that you cannot say that because I have got this atomic bomb, therefore I can conquer the whole world or whole universe. That is not possible. You can defend in your own way. And the dog can also defend in his own way. So a gorgeous method of defending, a gorgeous method of eating, a gorgeous method of sleeping, and a gorgeous method of sex life does not make a nation or a person advanced. That is not advanced. That is the same thing. Proportionately, 5 upon 2,000 upon 2,005 upon 20, the same ratio. Therefore, the animal qualities in a polished way, in a scientific way, does not mean that the human society is advanced. That may be called polished animalism. That's all. Real advancement means to know God. That is advanced.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna,